In 1872, Alan and I began our sixth African expedition, traveling into the very heart of it. Despite our guide's protest, we made camp in a clearing surrounded by lion statues. Judging by the many footprints and bone offerings, it was a local shrine. But Alan is fearless and always prepared with many guns. Our first few days were fruitful. We filled many cages with specimens. As I catalogued the photos and flower samples we'd gathered that day, I felt eyes upon me. It was just before evening tea time, but African nights are so dark that not even bright stars could ease my mind. Thankfully, many lanterns illuminated our camp. Earlier that day, I noticed some small bite marks on our food supplies. Something had raided our tent. I was nervous, so so I lit a cigarette. That morning, we found a wild boy rummaging through our tools. Although feral, he was curious, flipping through my books. Threatened to end the boy's life with a blade, claiming he was dangerous and nothing but a wild animal. I managed to stop him by using one of his own nets, regrettably not before he put a knife to the boy's throat. We argued, and Alan, filled with rage, stormed off alone. That didn't end well for him, but that is a story for another time.
Your disease is taking hold. You must hurry. Here are all the Vermillion Watch members. One of them must be able to solve this clue.
At your service, my friend. Ah. There's a partial maker's seal here. I have an extensive collection of items crafted by British fine jewelers. You'll find what you need here. Now we can clearly see the Maker's seal. He stopped working in 1864.
Where will your investigation take you next? He was once the best guide in Africa, but his hunting obsession drove him to madness and seclusion. Will you be his next kill?
What's going on out there? Well, no one would dare trespass.
Thank you. Oh. Thank you. Oh, Thank you.
after my falling out with Agnes. Rage consumed me like a fire. As I roamed the jungle alone, I became paranoid. It felt like even the shadows were after me. I noticed deep claw marks surrounding me. And for the first time, I felt the presence of mystical spirits. I had encroached on sacred ground. I had never been superstitious. Never even religious, until I came face to face with Gino Kali, which means sharp tooth. My foolish pride shattered as the great beast removed my lower jaw in one powerful swipe. Though badly wounded, I stood my ground and killed the beast. Once I realized I had destroyed a god, I realized I could hunt anything. And so I did.
Thank you.
Attack me. I've killed deadlier creatures than you in my sleep. Wait, is that you? So you're also infected. I may have underestimated you once, but never again.
Time is running out for you. I can smell it. Here are all the Vermillion Watch members. One of them must be able to solve this clue.
I'm always happy to help. This was finely crafted. My machine uses light to take precise measurements. Let's take a look.
The error, presume how. I. You.